I think it's perfectly normal, to be honest. I think some people just, everyone has their own different way of finding connections.
Their own fetishes and beliefs, so I don't think it's wrong, but I don't understand why they do it, but everyone has a background to why they engage in some pleasures, but if they use cybersex, then I'm not gonna judge that.
Feel that. Cybersex, I mean, if somebody wants to go out and do it, I mean, good for them. They got a right to do it. There's no law against it, so it's all good.
I think usually creepers who don't really have much of a sex life, you know, personally engage in cybersex.
I think that it's good. I think that some people need to express themselves without actually being in person.
Personally, I think it's kind of like pointless, just because it's basically, to my, you know, knowledge, it's basically like masturbation with somebody, you know, over the internet, just staring at a screen. I think it's like via webcam. Sometimes it's just chatting on the internet, but it's all like purpose driven to sexually stimulate people without actually having that person physically present.
So Messenger, you do the little dirty talks, there's like webcam chats I think you can do, and I don't know, even I think maybe, I don't know, phone, over the phone. Would
kind of engaging in sexual things with somebody else via a computer.
It's across the internet, and people tend to do it hiding themselves, and they're not actually having sex.
Alright, have you ever been on a chat room and the girl was like, A-S, age, sex, and place you from, and then that's opposite.
That one person's all like, hey, I'm horny. And the other person's like, cool, me too. And they kind of, you know, go from there, talking about their sexy parts and all that good stuff.
Starts out with ASL.
Oh, yeah,
reply with their ASL. Yeah. And it's usually in like a chat room, like a, I don't know, a lesbian chat room or something.
A role play.
Yeah.
I feel like anytime anything new comes out technology-wise, like, when it comes to communication, people are always going to apply sex to it. I think people are just sexual beings in general. So if you can have sex with it, people are going to try to.
Loneliness or just possibly a long-distance relationship. Or I guess that would kind of constitute loneliness. So. Or just, as he said first, being a creeper. I guess they have a right.
A failure to connect in the real world, I think. They can't find a person in concrete, so they go.
I guess they could be insecure with themselves and they feel that maybe it's like a barrier for them and they could open up that way. Or if there's like a distance within like a relationship or something.
Loneliness. Desperation. Lack of confidence. Inability to speak to women face to face.
The only advantages to cybersex is it's kind of like safer because there's no like physical contact. You don't have to worry about contracting or transmitting diseases. It's all and it's all virtual basically.
If you can't find anything else, I guess, or you're away from places,
with low self-esteem.
And you have low self-esteem, ugly.
No commitment, I think, is a big thing. People that don't want commitment, they just want to fling. They just go on and find a one-night partner.
You could do it whenever, wherever, I guess, potentially.
Sit at your computer, and you don't have to leave your house.
You don't actually have to meet the person. There's no emotional or physical attachment. It might be emotional, but it's nothing nearly as serious as the real thing. And you could always log off.
Disadvantages would have to be there's not actually like an intimate experience. It's really impersonal. It's just staring at a screen, you know. It's just obviously probably not as good as actual sex.
Those, well, the disadvantages of cyber sex compared to real sex is...
not real sex.
I guess sort of obvious in a way, but...
very obvious.
At the same time, if you want to shield yourself from them, I mean, it's beneficial on your part, I guess.
Don't get to have sex.
Get a bad internet connection.
Flesh. You can't touch. You can only touch your keyboard so many times.
I guess if I was in a long distance relationship, that would qualify for cybersex.
I don't think I would. It seems kind of weird.
I don't think I would. Personally, by myself, I wouldn't. If she wanted to do some kind of cyber swinging thing, I probably would, but figured if I have a woman that gives me what I want, then I'll stick with her.
Considering sexuality involved, like, things, I wouldn't trust anything on the internet. Like, I sometimes don't even trust, like, regular web chatting, let alone, like, doing sexual things on there. It's sketchy.
I would, just for poops and giggles.
I don't know. Maybe? I would.
If we were like together and all like giggly, like hee hee hee, that's cyber, we'd do it. I mean, not you and me. I mean,
I feel like if you were with someone you really loved and that was their thing, then maybe. But with someone else in your relationship, no, I wouldn't.
No. Because real sex is real sex. Cyber sex is fake shit that trolls do.
Oh, it's definitely a pleasure. I don't see how it could be a pathology's disease or something like that, right? Yeah, I don't see how it could be a... I mean, you can get addicted. Some people say they're addicted to porn or they're addicted to sex or something, but I think people just go on just to...
I feel like more nowadays it's starting to become more of a pathology, more of like an addiction, more of a almost a fetish, I feel like, rather than, you know, just something for fun.
Problem per se, because I mean, like I said, it just could be somebody if they're in a long distance relationship or they just have a hard time meeting people or they're in a new place and they just want to get off.
On the keyboard.
Because people are doing it to get pleasure. I mean, it could be connected to that, but I see it more as a pleasure because you keep doing it and you're enjoying it, so you're just gonna keep doing it for the pleasure.
It might be because our majority of the people that like do cyber sex, like really into that shit. That shit's sick.
I mean, cybersex is just one of those things that people do that you kind of can't believe that people really do. It's like, it's almost shocking that people can find so much pleasure from something so simple as, like, you and your computer screen and a possible other person on the other end. It's just definitely...
Some people enjoy it and other people don't. I don't necessarily think it's wrong, but I definitely feel like it's interesting.
I think people need to identify themselves correctly, otherwise it can lead to trouble.
I think it's an interesting thing that's come about because of the internet. I guess it's become more popular as of late.
The same amount that your cable bill and internet bill costs, you could use that to get a hooker. Thank you.